Hi all, and welcome to this seventh module of the course. In this series of videos, we are going to introduce the data linking process. Once we have generated our dataset based on any given data source, we should start thinking about how to link this dataset to other data sources, so as to guarantee that our data is not isolating, making it more useful, contextualized, and discoverable. That is, we have to identify links between our data and other data sources. What we see here in this picture is the link Open Data Cloud, a graphical representation of the most representative link datasets. Each bubble on the image corresponds to a dataset, and each arrow denotes links between them. This version of the LOD Cloud corresponds to 2014, as today's version is just simply too large to be rendered as we see. Datasets are classified in color, denoting their category, for example, publications in green, geographical information, government, etc. The big bubble we see on the center of the image is the Wikipedia, which, as we will see, contains information from Wikipedia but annotated as RDF. As it contains tons of information from different domains, from many datasets, most of the arrows from the different bubbles in the LOD Cloud tend to point to the Wikipedia, which it's what we are going to do as well on the second video of this module. So, this is our purpose with data linking. We want to make sure that our data is not isolated, and for that, we have a set of steps, four main steps that we can perform to do that. First, we have to identify categories, that is, classes in our dataset that can be linked to other datasets. That means classes that we can find in other datasets. In general, we will talk about popular classes or classes that are general enough to be found in different data sources. Then we have to identify datasets that may contain those classes. If we are talking about cities, for example, we need to find datasets that contain information about cities. Then we have to select tools, and we will see later which tools we can use, and so an example about it. So we need a tool that fits our needs, and finally, we have to tune this tool to our purposes and execute it to obtain the links. So how this is done? How can we do this process? How can we identify other resources that are similar to ours or that can be linked to our resources? There are different categories of matching, different matching processes that we can execute, isolated or combined. The first one is value matching, which we determine whether two values of two properties are the same or equivalent enough. That is, we state that two objects are the same based on techniques such as, for example, string similarity, the use of keywords, or exploiting their semantic relation using services such as, for example, WordNet. When using this, we have to be careful because we cannot always conclude that two individuals with a property match are the same. For that, we need to ensure that they are matched at the individual and the individual level. For this, we can use the description of the instances, such as, for example, the RDFS level or comment that we introduced on the RDF video, or other vocabulary, such as, for example, doubling core. The goal here is to decide if two individuals represent the same real-world object or not. If the descriptions are similar enough, we can conclude that those individuals probably are the same, are there certain confidence degree. We can use value matching techniques that we introduced before, or rely on properties such as all same as, that identifies two individuals to be equivalent, or using mappings between ontologies for aligning classes and finding matches between their individuals. Finally, we can look for matches at the dataset level. That is, we can analyze the information about both datasets, the origin and the target one, as a whole in this case. We get the individual match from those datasets and refine the links based on the information about the dataset. We can understand these categories, value matching, individual matching, and dataset matching, as an incremental process in which each process is built upon the results of the previous one. So here we have some of the most relevant tools for matching datasets. Each of one implements one or more of the techniques introduced before. And these tools, what they aim is to automatize the process. But in many cases, we have to assist the process in order to guarantee that the results are correct. And of course, in any case, after applying these tools, we have to check whether the results that we have obtained are valid or not, or if we have to refine them in any way. So let's see how can we implement the linking process using an example. Here in the slide, we see the schema modeling buildings are their energy consumption as described by the open data portal of the city of Leeds. If this was to be our dataset, the first thing we need to do, as we introduced before, is to identify the classes with potential matches. In this case, taking a look around, we see things such as observation, for example, time intervals, which are not really common or not really easy to match. But we have others such as, for example, civil structure or places or cities that are quite popular and that we can find in other datasets. So we will select city, place, and civic structure. The second thing to do is to select the target dataset. In this case, we are selecting DVpedia. We are going to explore this dataset in order to obtain matching instances. And finally, the tool that we are going to use. In this case, we are going to use OpenRefine, an open source tool based on Google Refine. It supports many activities such as data analysis, cleaning, and transformation based on CSV files for transforming CSV files. And it also includes an RDF extension plugin that allows us to transform the data we have processed into RDF and find links to external resources. We'll introduce this tool later on this video. So overall, what we want to do in our example is to take the data from the city of Leeds and use OpenRefine, the RDF extension of OpenRefine, to find links to DVpedia, as we know that DVpedia has information about cities, which is contained in Wikipedia. So the result that we will obtain will look like this. First, we have here the information about the city of Leeds. We have this individual representing Leeds, which belongs to the schema place class, and that has a label with its name with the value Leeds. On the other hand, we will have DVpedia, which contains as well an entity representing the city of Leeds, belonging to the same class and with a description label with the name Leeds. So if we are able to run our process and obtain that they are both the same individual, state that they are both same as, all same as, which is a property stating that two individuals represent the same concept from the real world, we will have access to a lot of information. This information includes, for example, geolat, a property stating the latitude, information about the area, in which country Leeds is located, an abstract description, its time zone, or even links to other resources from other DVpedias, such as, for example, in this case, the Japanese DVpedia. DVpedia works based on languages, so we have a version of the DVpedia for each language. It's not based on regions or countries, but on languages. So we will have the English DVpedia, which is the main one, the Spanish one, the Japanese, or the Italian, etc. So in this link over here, you can get all the information about Leeds, for example, which is the example we are using, about the city and its related annotations. So you will find a lot of triples describing how Leeds is related to other resources, the name, as we saw before, the country, the abstract description, and links to other resources on other DBpedias or other data sources. So by linking our results from our dataset with the DBpedia one, we have access to a lot of information that we don't have to implement. We don't have to do any work to get all the information because it is already available on DBpedia. That's the value of having linked data. With this, we conclude the introduction to the process of data linking, which is a fundamental step when producing linked data. In the following video, we will show how to use OpenRefine, the tool we introduced before, to obtain these links.